Today we are going to discuss about the valence bond theory. Valence bond theory. So here in valence bond theory, we know that the bonding will take place by overlapping of orbitals, right? Bonding will occurs by overlapping of orbitals. So for the example, if you will consider, here there is a one atom and here there is another atom, and if they are onto the distance r, so the potential energy between these two atoms will be given by k q1 q2 by r. If r is on infinite distance, if these two atoms will be taken as on the infinite distance, so the potential energy will become zero. So to understand this overlapping, we will consider the bonding in H2 molecule. So here I have a one hydrogen molecule and here I have a another hydrogen molecule, right? As we know that hydrogen have only one orbital, which is 1s1, right? Here also 1s1. So if these two atoms are at some distance, and if we will decrease the distance, then what happen? Then the orbitals of this hydrogen atom, its nucleus, the same way the another atom and its electron in its orbital, this is its nucleus. So the nucleus of this atom will attract the electron of this orbital, and nucleus of this atom will attract the electron of this atom. So like that way the distance will decrease and they will come at a certain distance where they can overlap to each other. That certain distance is known as a bond length, right? Where the your potential energy will be minimum. Potential energy will be minimum and stability will be maximum. Stability will be maximum, right? So how we can count that potential energy actually? So to count the potential energy, as we know that here there are protons and electrons are involved, so there are some kind of repulsive forces and attractive forces are there. But when two atoms are approaches to each other, right, here like in this case, when they are certain distance, the amount of attractive forces will be maximum. So for the potential energy, we can given like this way, where k, q1, q2. So here we are considering that attractive forces are maximum. So attractions can be only occurs when the one value is in positive and one value is in negative. So overall, if we will decrease the value of r, right, which is the distance between the two atoms, then what we will get? The overall potential energy will be in negative, right? So by decreasing the distance r, actually potential energy will be decreased. Potential energy will be decreased, right? And stability will increase, and stability will increases. So what happen if we will just continuously decrease the distance? As we know that once we had achieved the overlapping, the maximum overlapping and maximum stability, but still what I will do? Still I will decrease the distance. So as I had told you that this distance will be called as the bond length, but still I will, what I am doing, I am decreasing the distance, I am just decreasing the bond length or something like that. Then I will say that the value of r is less than the bond length d. Suppose this is your bond length d, then what happen? Then the two nucleus will come so close to each other, the same way two electron will close to so close to each other, and the repulsive forces will dominant than the attractive forces. Then what happen? As we know that the repulsive forces are maximum, then in this equation here this will become positive and this will become also positive, or this will become negative and this will also become negative, because as we are considering here the repulsive forces are the dominant forces. So here the value of potential energy will come in positive. So potential energy will increases and stability decreases. And stability decreases, right? So same thing we can also represent it like a one simple diagram, where here we are taking the potential energy on the axis, or here we are taking the r distance r between two atoms. Suppose initially the two atoms are at the infinite distance, but as I will decrease the distance, what happen? They will come, by decreasing the distance, they will come at a particular position where the your potential energy will be minimum, right? So here it's a position where your particular value of r, your potential energy will be minimum, right? So when your potential energy is minimum, your stability will be maximum. Stability will be maximum. So this distance is your actually bond length. This is your bond length. But after achieving the bond length, still you are decreasing the distance, and what repulsive forces will become the dominant, and your mole will, your stability will decrease and potential energy will continuously increase. And at one stage, the your repulsive energy will be so much dominant that bond will be break down, and again the two molecule will be separates and they will be go at a certain distance. So these are the basic of valence bond theory. There are certain criteria which we can see in the valence bond theory. The first will be overlapping occurs between two half fill orbital, between two half fill orbital in some region, right? So in valence bond theory, at some region the two orbitals will be get overlap and bond formation will be take place. Second point, in coordinate covalent bond overlapping take place between filled orbital and vacant orbital. So using the coordinate covalent bond, the electron will donate by, or electron will be shed by only one orbital, right? Third point is, more will be the strength of bond. It means that more will be the strength of bond, right? So here we can say that the directional orbitals do more overlapping than the undirectional orbital. What is mean by directional and undirectional orbital? Such as example, if you will take the s orbital, right? So the electron density in the s orbital in every direction are same. Like if I will go in this direction or this direction, the electron densities are same. So this is undirectional orbital. That is why it is considered as the undirectional orbital, right? So if the overlapping occurs with such kind of orbital, that overlapping will be not that much. But if you will consider some directional orbital such as p orbital or dd orbital, where the electron density are particular in some region or some area, right? So here it is considered as the directional orbital, and it will do more overlapping. So for the example, we can say that the if overlapping is occurring between the 2d orbital or overlapping is between the 2s orbital, so here will be more overlap, right? So here will be the more strength of bond, here bond will be the more strength. Or in some way we can also describe it like the on the basis of size. As we know, the s orbital, a size of s orbital is less than p orbital, p is less than d orbital, and d is less than f orbital. This is the order of size, right? So if overlapping occurs, right, so on the basis of this we can say the 3s 3s overlapping is less than 3s 3p overlapping, 3s 3p overlapping is less than 3p 3p overlapping, and it is less than 3d 3d overlapping, because here the size play the major role, because s orbitals have a lesser size, so lesser overlapping. As the size increase, the overlapping will also increase and strength of bond will also increase. So here you can say this is the maximum strength of bond. In here the strength of bond is more than all of this orbital, because here the size of orbitals are more, so the strength of bond will be also more here, right? The fourth point we will see here, if the orbitals are closer to the nucleus, then it will form the more stronger bond, right? If orbital are more closer to nucleus, it forms stronger bond. It forms stronger bond, right? As we know that the s orbitals are more closer than the p orbitals, p orbitals are more closer than the d orbitals, and the same way d orbitals are more closer than the f orbitals. And in the same case we can say the 1s orbitals are more closer than the 2s, 2s is more closer than the 3s. So 1s orbital will be make more stronger bond because it is more closer to the nucleus. So 1s orbitals, 1s overlapping is more stronger than the 2s, right? 2s is more stronger than the 3s, and 3s is more stronger than the 4s, right? The same way we can say it for the 2p orbitals, right? So 2p or overlapping is more stronger than the 3p overlapping because it is more closer to the nucleus. The same way 3p is more closer to the nucleus, so it is more stronger. And the same way we can say for the 5p, so this will be the strength of bond. So for the example we can take the one example, like if we have a covalent bond between Cl2 Br2 and I2, now which one have a more stronger covalent bond if we want to find it out. So how we will say it? So here the outermost orbitals are the 3p orbitals, right? So if I will consider the two chlorine atoms are overlapping with each other, then the as we know that in bonding outermost shell will be participate. So here which one is the outermost shell? 3p. Here is which one is the outermost shell? 3p. So here 3p overlapping are, right? Here is 3p. In same case for the bromine, it's a 4p overlapping, and for the iodine it's a 5p overlapping. So from the criteria we had seen that 3p is more closer to the nucleus, so it will be more stronger overlapping than the 4p and then the 5p. So the here is more overlapping than the bromine, here is more overlapping than the iodine. The strength of bond will be chlorine is more stronger than the bromine is more stronger than the iodine in the bond, right? Same way, the more stronger the bond, the more lesser will be the bond length, right? So here stronger bond is there, so lesser bond length will be there. So for the bond length we can say that Cl2 is less than Br2, Br2 is less than I2. This will be order of bond length, right? This will be the order of bond length while here we are talking about the strength, right? So there are normally two kind of overlapping are there, so which makes